Hi everyone, this is Ruben, Zcoin's community manager, and I'm here to give you some updates on what's been happening with Zcoin in the past week. We finally released our core upgrade to 0.13, which has gone quite well. The only thing left remaining is to get the mining pools to upgrade, which should stabilize the network significantly. They're currently waiting for us to get some updated code, which should be done either today or tomorrow, and hopefully we can get everyone on the new call by the end of the week. We are actually also mulling on launching our own pool because right now, like, all the hash rate is being concentrated at mining pool hub and only a really little bit at Supernova, so we might launch our own pool. We'll see what happens in our resources, but just temporarily while more pools launch. Now, once the mining pools upgrade, we expect this will reduce those having stuck transactions and stuck blocks, and hopefully all nodes will move to the new core quite soon. And for those of you who are having those stuck transactions, this can actually be rebroadcast quite easily. Just contact me on Slack under the name Ruben and PM me with your raw transaction data, which you can get by right-clicking on your stuck transaction and pasting it to me. Now, those having stuck zero coin spend transactions are a bit more complicated. Just wait a bit more. We're coming up with an easy method to rebroadcast these as well, but probably need to wait for the pools to upgrade. So, we know it's frustrating. I have some stuck spend transactions as well. So we'll have an update for that soon. Now on the ZEF project, the Zerocoin Ethereum project, Ryodan is progressing very well. He actually hit a small roadblock, but actually Vitalik kindly, clarified the matter to him, and now he is still on schedule of coming out with a proof of concept ZEF mixer before DEFCON, which I think is in early November. So, DEFCON will be attended by both Poramin and Ryodan, so we hope to reach out to the Ethereum community and show them what we've got. On that note, during the past week, we were made aware of an ICO called ZToken that was actually using our logo. We actually reached out to them and they have kindly agreed to take it down and not use our material anymore. Just to clarify, the ZToken project has no relation to us, despite also intending to use Zerocoin. And it's actually more in relation to having a separate token of Ethereum rather than a decentralized mix for Ethereum. So we have no relation to the ZToken project, and I think moving forward, there should not be any confusion as they stop using our materials. On the marketing end, we are working on our website relaunch. There have been some minor delays, but the designer has been working through the weekend, and we hope to get it sometime this week. I'm personally actually very excited at how it looks and hope you give a more professional and approachable face to Zcoin. Currently, the website's really nice, but has a bit of a matrix hackery feel, which we want to distance ourselves from. Since our, just a sort of an update on Twitter, since our increased focus to grow organically on Twitter, this has actually yielded very good results with us more than doubling our followers in the past 28 days, tripling our profile visits, and actually doubling our mentions. We hope to continue to engage the community via Twitter, but there's been some community members that voiced out there have been some concerns on the informal nature of our Twitter posts and more like the replies, especially with our use of short forms. Like, for example, instead of saying thanks, we put down THX. And the use of memes when replying to users. The short forms were actually there to maintain within the 140 character limit of Twitter, and the memes were actually meant to inject some humor and humanity to our project rather than giving a totally corporate feel, because we don't really feel that's how our project's like. We think in cryptocurrency, especially anonymous cryptocurrency, a grassroots feeling is really important. But we are open to criticism, and we do understand the concerns and the pros and cons of this. But really, we like to hear more feedback from the community on this, and You know, if a lot of our community feels that we should have a very professional feel, no memes, no short forms, just very formal announcements, then not a problem. We will change our communication method through that. Our communications and PR through our blog and official announcement will, however, always remain formal and professional, so you don't have to worry about that. We have actually, on the marketing end, we have actually approached a few professional marketing companies, and waiting for them to revert to us. Actually, this has taken a bit longer since marketing in the cryptocurrency space is rather new to them, but they're very established marketing companies that have worked for multinational companies, and we understand the need for a strong creative message so that Zcoin can reach a wider audience. And we've already set aside a sizable budget for this, so hopefully we can improve on that. And we know we are lacking on this end, especially when compared to other coins with maybe less interesting technology. We've also contracted a series of tutorial videos to guide newcomers on how to get Zcoin, even how to buy it from Bitrex. That's one of the most common questions people come to us, and also quick tutorials on how to use the wallet, which we expect to be done sometime this week as well. Now, I think everyone's been watching this for Znotes, and it's probably the most hot topic right now. For those of you who aren't familiar, Znotes is a way to incentivize people to host full nodes of Zcoin and to keep them updated to the latest version for network stability. Now, there are other features that will be built upon them, but the first iteration should be a simple implementation where Znode holders will earn a proportion of the block reward, and that is divided among Znode holders. So actually, the less Znode holders, the more you get, but we don't want to make it too exclusive. We haven't confirmed the returns of Znode holders yet, and it also depends on the take-up rate of how many people would be hosting Znodes. But it should be relatively similar to Dasher during its early implementation of Masternodes. As for the burning question, how many Zcoin for a Znode? We'll make a official announcement closer to launch, but we expect it to be in the several hundreds to low thousands. We haven't really decided yet, but roughly around that range. To strike a balance between affordability and profitability. We don't know ourselves. We really have to take a look at, the distribution and how much Zcoin is worth then. The other burning question is when will Znotes launch? Now this is an estimate, so don't hold us too hard on it, as it may be sooner or later, but our initial estimate is about 4 to 6 weeks. So that puts us at about early late October or early November. We'll keep you posted if there are any changes or delays to this. But yeah, this is our initial estimate. Shoot. SN is quite confident, but I rather not make any hard deadlines until we're very, very sure. But this is just to let you know that this is not gonna take months and months of work. But this is our initial estimate. Prior to that, we will launch the security update to LibZeroCoin, the software library to ZeroCoin that incorporates many improvements to ZeroCoin, and we are set to release that in a week or two. This is a major development actually, because LibZeroCoin hasn't been changed in over 4 years, and this actually represents a very big improvement in security for the ZeroCoin protocol. And we know there are a few other projects that are utilizing ZeroCoin, and we highly recommend these projects to utilize and adopt these fixes as soon as we make it available, as we are committed to open source technology, and the last thing we want is having other people having a less than ideal ZeroCoin implementation. There have been no updates on MTP just yet. We're still awaiting the update from the researchers on their proposed improvements to it before we can give an estimated time of launch. So just stay tuned. If you want to take a look, you can check out Dimitri and Alexei's work from the University of Luxembourg. These are the people we're waiting for. when they do launch the paper, then we'll be able to give you a more accurate estimate there. But meanwhile, actually, a lot of people are discovering that the Lyra 2Z algorithm that we're currently using is actually quite decent for the moment. You know, GPUs right now only have a 4 times advantage over CPUs, so it's not that bad, especially when the GPUs cost around that much, about 4 times more than the CPU. And they're actually very light on the GPU due to its use of shared memory. So you actually notice that it runs very cool, your GPU is only warm, not hot, and you know, the electricity consumption is a lot lower. So for those of you with high electricity costs or where temperatures are a concern, or want to keep your miners running silently, Lyra 2Z may be the right algorithm for you. We're also in the process of hiring a user interface designer to redesign our wallet interface to improve usability and have a bit more eye candy, because frankly, you know, Bitcoin QT wallet looks really, you know, everyone has this and it looks kind of old. We hope to have a more interesting front end for this. So this ends the quick video and update on what has been happening with Zcoin and what is in store for us in the near future. This gives some clarity as to what we're doing and not just sitting on our laurels. But if you have any other questions, please do not hesitate to reach out. But you know, for the love of all that is goodness, well, please stop asking me about Znotes. I've already given all the information that you need to know, and that's all I have to share on that matter. Thanks very much, and thanks for supporting Zcoin. Thank you.